हेलो एंड वेलकम यू ऑल। आई प्रोफेसर विपिन चोपड़े फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग साइंसेस एट AISSMS इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी पुणे। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ टॉपिक लेथ मशीन फ्रॉम मशीन टूल्स।
सो वट आर द लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस टॉपिक दैट your students must be familiar with the concept of machine tool, what is lathe machine and its use, what are the various parts of the lathe machine that we are going to cover in today's session. Let's see what is meant by machine tool. A machine tool is a specific type of machine which gives desired shape, size and finish to a raw material by removing excess of material in the form of small chips and burrs. Means a device which removes or which performs certain kind of operation on a raw material to get into final size and shape, that device is called as machine tool. The next definition is of cutting tool. A cutting tool is which removes the excess material through a direct mechanical contact. A cutting tool is a device which removes material through a direct contact, which is called as cutting tool. Then machine tool provides relative motion between workpiece and cutting tool. Machine tool is nothing but a machine which provides a relative motion between workpiece and cutting tool. Because of this action, your production process starts, and through this relative motion of tool with respect to workpiece, the excess material in the form of small chips and burrs are removed out, and your final size, shape, finished product is at your end. Next is metal cutting or manufacturing machining process. What is meant by machining process? A method which is used to obtain desired shape, size and finish part from a raw material by removing excess of material in the form of small chips and burrs is called as a machining process. Means a machining process is a process by virtue of which we can convert a raw material into final finished parts. There are several kinds of machine tools are available, such as lathe machine, drilling machine, grinding machine, milling machine and shaper machine, etc. Let's talk about lathe machine in detail. So what is meant by lathe machine? Yes, it is also called as mother of all machines because almost all operations are performed on lathe machines are possible. Hence, it is called as mother of all machines. Lathe machine is a power-driven machine tool which is useful in producing cylindrical workpieces. As your metal piece is to be machined is rotated in the lathe. So, lathe machine is a machine tool in which your workpiece is fitted in a chuck. Here, your workpiece is fitted, and this chuck is rotating along the spindle. That's why your workpiece is also rotated. And your cutting tool is single point cutting tool, which helps to remove the excess material from this workpiece to get into final shape and size of the part. These are the major parts of the lathe machine. This is headstock. This one is your tailstock. This one is your bed. Then this is your carriage. This one is your cross slide. This one is your tool holder. This one is your compound rest. Let's see the construction of lathe machine in detail. What are the important parts of lathe machine? Your first part is headstock. It is generally present at the left hand side of your lathe machine. Headstock is generally manufactured by the process of casting. And what is the function of headstock? It provides the driving power to the control rotation of the workpiece. So on the headstock main function is to support the spindle, and on the spindle your chuck is rotating. So what is the main function of headstock? It provides the driving motion to the workpiece. Then your headstock also contain a spindle to which various work holding attachments are fitted. Next important element is bed. Again, it is manufactured with the process of casting. Its main function is to provide mainframe for the support of the workpiece and tool during machining operation. This is your lathe bed manufactured with the help of casting. And the main function of this bed is to withstand higher amount of the forces which is occurring in a cutting operation. Next important element is your carriage. The figure shows a carriage assembly. What is the function of carriage? It controls and supports the cutting tool composed of number of parts. Power is transmitted to the carriage through the feed mechanism. This regulates the amount of the tool travel per revolution of the spindle. Carriage gets the power through the feed mechanism by virtue of your lead screw. And what is the function of this is carriage? It supports the cutting tool. It supports the cutting tool and composed number of parts. Means what? See here, your tool post is there. Your cutting tool is mounted in tool post. That's why this carriage is supposed to support the cutting tool. And again, there are several parts in a carriage assembly, such as tool rest, compound rest, cross slide, saddle, and apron. Let's go in detail one by one what is carriage assembly is. So what are the carriage part? First part is your saddle. What is the saddle? Saddle is fitted to the ways of the bed and slides along them. Saddle is useful in sliding motion. The next important part is apron. Here is your apron, which provides drive mechanism. It can be using hand or power feed, means manual or automatic driving mechanism can be performed through apron. Next is your cross slide. Cross slide allows tool to move in and out, means towards the operator and away from the operator. Next one is your compound slide. It allows the tool to move at any angle. So compound rest will allows the tool to swivel at any angle. Then next is your tool rest. It is used to mount the cutting tool. Let's go to the previous slide and see what are the important function of carriage assembly. So your first part is saddle. Here is your saddle, which is helpful in sliding motion. It is generally located on the guideways of your bed. Then next one is your cross slide. This is your cross slide, which is helps in and out motion for the cutting tool towards and away from the operator. Then this one is your compound rest, which helps in the angular operation, means your cutting tool will swivel at a required angle by virtue of this compound rest. And last important part is your tool rest or tool post. Here it will support your cutting tool, or your cutting tool is fitted in a tool post for cutting operation. And this one is your apron. What is the function of apron? It will provide the driving mechanism to the carriage assembly, and that driving mechanism can be mechanically by using this hand wheel or automatically. So these are the important parts of carriage assembly. Next important part is lead screw. What is the function of lead screw? Lead screw transmit the power to the carriage through a gearing and clutch arrangement in the carriage apron. So the function of lead screw is nothing but a power transmission to a carriage. A power feed lever, this one is the power feed lever, which is located on the carriage apron. The power feed lever activates either the longitudinal power feed of the carriage or cross feed of the cross slide. So this is a power feed lever which actuates the power feed to the carriage and the cross slide. Next important part of the lathe machine is your tailstock, which is present at the right hand side of the your machine. Again, it is manufactured with the help of casting only. The main function of this tailstock is to support the workpiece when the length of the workpiece is very long. And again, the second important function of this tailstock is to determine the center of your workpiece. This tailstock plays an important role in operations such as drilling, boring. This tailstock also supports the drill bit and boring bar in case of drilling and boring operations. Next important parts are your work holding devices. Chucks are there for work holding devices. These chucks are mounted on the spindle of your headstock. There are two kinds of chucks, three jaw chuck and four jaw chuck. On the left hand side here, three jaw chuck is there. There are having three jaws. A three jaw chuck is a universal chuck holds. This three jaw chuck is generally used to hold the cylindrical or hexagonal work pieces, while this four jaw chuck is generally used to hold a square bars. This is the important difference between three jaw chuck and four jaw chuck. Three jaw chuck is a universal chuck which holds cylindrical or hexagonal workpiece. All three jaws move together to bring the work on center. And what about four jaw chuck? The four jaw chuck are reversible and can hold different sizes and shapes of the work pieces. Each jaw can be moved independently. This is the difference between three jaw chuck and four jaw chuck. So guys, I think this will clear you about the components of lathe machine, the construction of lathe machine, what is in by machine tool, what is in by machining process, why lathe machine is called as mother of all machines, what are the important parts of lathe machine. I hope you will be clear in this concept. Okay, thank you. Thank you all.